There is very little known about doctors in the Umayyad period, 661 through 750 AD. Certainly, it is not possible that in all of this vast region, from Damascus all through India and China, there were two doctors in Kufa, which is in today's Iraq, another in Basra, and one in Asia Minor. The interesting observation that has been made by many historians is that most of the doctors during the Umayyad times were Christians of a Roman origin. This was probably because of the fact that Christians were well knowledgeable of Greek language. The list of medical doctors known in this period are Prince Khalid bin Yazid bin Muawiyah was perhaps the first Arab to have studied chemistry. He also studied medicine, but no documentation as to whether he practiced it or not. He died in 704 AD. He wrote 10 volumes on chemistry and chemistry-related issues, including a diwan or collection of poetry on chemistry. Abu al-Hakam al-Dimashqi was known for his pharmaceutical work during the reign of the Caliph Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan, whose reign was from 661 through 680 AD. Abu al-Hakam al-Dimashqi died at the age of 100 without publishing or leaving behind any medical work. His son, al-Hakam al-Dimashqi, was said to have cured sick people with scientific approach, but he too did not leave any documented work. He died in 805 AD at the age of 105 during the reign of the Abbasid era, Al-Ma'mun. Ibn al-Hakam al-Dimashqi lived majority of his life during the Abbasid era. Therefore, he could be categorized as an Abbasi doctor. He died in 839. Ibn al-Hakam al-Dimashqi had written several books. Among them are books on the benefits of animals, on the nerve system, and variety of medications. Ibn Athal was a Christian. He studied in the same school in which al-Dimashqi family studied. The Caliph Muawiyah trusted him a great deal. Tiyadhuq was a Christian and the best amongst medical doctors at that time. He was very interesting doctor that al-Hajjaj bin Yusuf al-Thaqafi entrusted and depended on him a great deal. The reason I said he was interesting, an interesting doctor, is because in maintaining one's health and in preventing what might cause discomfort or sickness, he warned, "Do not drink cold water on an empty stomach. Do not eat until you are hungry. Do not intercourse when your stomach is full. Do not withhold urine for a long time. Do not make love unless to a female. Do not eat meat unless fresh and young. Eat fresh fruit, sleep after lunch, and have a walk after dinner, even if on thorns. Do not eat what makes your teeth weak and weakens your stomach's digestion. Don't drink medicine unless you need it. Don't put food in your mouth when there is food already." Tiyadhuq published 4 large volumes on medicine. His birth and death dates are unavailable. Another medical doctor was Furat bin Shahnata, who was a Jew and Tiyadhuq's student. He lived all through the Abbasid Caliph Abi Ja'far al-Mansur and died in 836. Abdul Malik al-Kinani was a Christian who taught at al-Iskandariya school. He contacted Prince Umar bin Abdul Aziz, who ruled Egypt and eventually became one of his doctors. Umar bin Abdul Aziz was the reason behind al-Kinani's conversion to Islam. His birth and death dates are unavailable. Zainab bin Aoud was a female doctor from the famous Arab Qahtani tribe. The great historian and ophthalmologist Ibn Abi Usaybah mentioned her in his book Al-Uyun, or The Eyes, page 181, along with other Muslim doctors. His mention of Zainab was recorded in a more recent book by Dr. Kamal Samarra'i in Arabic language, which can be found at the reference section of the Boston Public Library. Zainab was an ophthalmologist who cured eye sickness and performed surgery, but of course, in the world dominated by men, her work did not have a chance to be recorded. The Abbasid doctors, when Baghdad was the capital of the Muslim world. Dr. Abu Hunayn Ishaq al-Ibadi, we know very little about him. He mixed remedies and produced medicine for doctors. His son, Hunayn bin Ishaq al-Ibadi, has already been assessed as the great translator of Greek works. He did not limit himself to pure reception, however, but independently composed many medical monographs. A work on ophthalmology exists under his account, Kitab al-Ashr Maqalat fil Ayn, as the title state, consists of 10 articles that were written in the course of 30 years and then made into a book. It formed the starting point for the important specialized ophthalmological literature produced by the Arabs and was translated into Latin. He published his large book on diet, Kitab al-Aghdiyah, in both Arabic and Syriac. The book comprises of three parts. The first contains general pronouncements on foodstuffs. The second discusses food from seeds and fruits. And in the third, from plants and animals. In the course of his life, he wrote 139 books. Hunayn died in 873. Ishaq bin Hunayn studied under his father, died at the age of 83 in 911 AD. He translated and wrote his own 23 books. Ishaq bin Hunayn translated from the Greek works less than his father in medicine, but more in philosophy.